Well, hello, dears. It is I, Professor Knestor Jackdaws, and I hope you're doing very well. I'm outdoors, and you can see I'm breaking with tradition. I'm not wearing my tweed at the moment because it's so bloody hot here at Oxmouth. We're undergoing some kind of a heat wave, and which happens from time to time. Anyway, I hope you don't mind. I'm just here in my shirt sleeves. Talking to you today about something I noticed in the news, which was there was a student in London at one of the colleges there who has done a piece of what's called performance art. You know, and that can really range to a lot of different sort of activities. Though I remember one in New York where, you know, the artist laid down on the gallery floor naked with a box of pushpins. There's little plastic pushpins and a little sign that says, "Stick pins in me," words to that effect. And, you know, people stuck some pins in the fellow. And anyway, that's a sort of, still gives me chills to think about it, performance art. But there are all different kinds, aren't there? There's, you know, musical, audible ones, and there are ones that are, you go, oh, really? It just looks like somebody dug a ditch and put the dirt rather sloppily to the side, and that's considered performance art. But in this case, there was a load of carrots, I assume fresh carrots, nearly, it said in the report, nearly 32 tons of carrots were dumped onto a driveway near this school in London, and that was all part of the Master of Fine Arts project of this young artist. One wonders how he was preparing for this. Over the years, was he, you know, taking bushels of cauliflower and putting them in one place or another? How exactly does one build up to one's, you know, magnum opus of nearly 32 tons? 32 tons, mind you, of fresh carrots. Now, one might think that that's a tremendous waste of food, but apparently, according to the artist, that was the whole point. Was to point out and make draw attention to, put the focus on the incredible amounts of food that are being wasted somewhere by somebody. And, you know, what better way, I think, to demonstrate wasting food than by wasting nearly 32 tons of carrots. Of course, they weren't all put to waste. Apparently, the intention, whether it actually happened or not, the intention was to feed animals with these 32 tons of carrots. So the food didn't really go to waste at all. It just quickly made a point and then disappeared somewhere to be consumed by hoofed beasts. It just points out the fact that art can be nearly anything when it's done by human beings, because art, of course, expresses, it's just some sort of product of creativity and imagination. You know, so if someone writes, something like Gertrude Stein used to write, which is one repetitive or mainly repetitive sentence over and over again for pages and pages, it is, call it what you will, an expression of creativity and imagination. I mean, she had to think it up. She had to think, this is a work of art. And then she had to get it published and, you know, cajole people into turning the pages. What is my point? My point is that whereas there are these things that we can laugh about and we can point to with derision and with great suspicion, you know, and I can only imagine this particular art installation, performance art with the carrots, I can only imagine the sort of narrative evaluations that the professorship there is going to give this person. Whatever we might think about these things, they truly do all fall under the category of art and are perfectly acceptable. And one should never really put the brakes on too much, either on oneself or another person who endeavours to create such a work of art, such a non-traditional work of art. Because indeed, sometimes, I imagine in London, you know, dozens and dozens of people walk by that pile of carrots, very tall, must have been at least 2.5 metres tall, and you know, scoffed at it and turned up their noses and, you know, maybe pilfered a carrot or two to have later and to throw into the stew. Maybe that's why it was just a little bit under 32 tons. Maybe nearly a ton of it was, you know, what they call shrinkage. But I imagine there were people that came by and said, oh, you know, this is exactly what I needed to see. This clarifies everything. This raises my spirits. This proves a point I've always made or something like that, and which, you know, is very worthwhile. Whether it's worth all the time and effort and expense of nearly 32 tons of carrots is beyond the point. So just a long way, I suppose, of saying, as silly as it might be, don't stop yourself. If you have an artistic impulse, get it out. You'll learn from it. It may be a great deal of trouble. It may be something that will haunt you later. But in any case, you will learn, and perhaps someone will have an epiphany. An epiphany is in rather short supply. They're certainly less common than carrots. Well, there you go. Just my thoughts for today. Stay cool. Stay healthy. I'm Professor Knestor Jackdaws. I'll see you again. Ta-ta.